to put some mojito and so much pressure on it.
There's very little tape on Ocampo.
Yeah.
What you've seen, what does he do well?
A lot of things, he's able to create distance well. He has a good jab. He counterpunches pretty well. We've been working on that, counterpunching. Well, not arrow counterpunching, but preparing for the counterpunch. Working on the actual way he creates distance. Which he already said he's going to create distance. He already said he's going to use his ranges. I mean, you're sitting there talking to the guy. He's right here at you, got the same height. So where's the distance, the arm range? So I think that in his mind, if you go back and watch video on him, everybody's fighting, he's a lot taller than him. So he's fighting undersized guys, but now he's fighting a guy with his size or his height, because Errol is still more massive and more big and more developed than he is. So, but we'll see, man.
At what point did you realize that Errol was special? Was it an age or just a point?
You know what? I think that once after we started training and he finally got everything I was teaching him, I was working with him on, and he started to implement it, which was good, but when he started to make it his own, which when you say that's what made him really special, I believe, that when he took everything I was teaching him, and then you would see him kind of like bag it and bring it out, present it in a different manner, and that's what made it special for me.
How do you and Errol stay grounded? Is it just a Texas thing? You guys have accomplished a lot, especially last year, Charlo knocking out mandatories, Errol getting the title. How do you guys stay humble during this whole process?
I don't think it's a big deal. I think that I look at it as if, I think a big deal is if I went out and I went to fed a million people. That's a big deal. I'm gonna walk out with my chest sticking out. I've been boxing since I was 4 or 5 years old. So if you think about that, this is just what you've been doing. Is it interesting that we're doing it? Yeah, but I think that not enough big deal to where you can go out and embarrass yourself, be pompous, be arrogant. I don't think it's like that, because and then I fed a million people. You won't stop me from talking. I'm just saying, so that's when I think it's a big deal. This is like kind of what we do.
So what happens in this performance, you feel? Because I know there's a lot of eyes on Errol at this moment. So I know he's training hard in his training camp as well. From what you see, what happens?
I don't know, man. Really, it's not so much about him, it's so much about Carlos Ocampo. So whatever he does, if he can take the punches, if he can take the position, whatever. So that's what. So the expectations are, I have no idea. So everything is situational. I mean, so you can't like. I make it easy for myself by not trying to think it all the way through.
Yeah, you told me it drives you nuts.
Well, it can drive you crazy, yeah. Right? So I take it for what it is, and so I don't put so much of my time into it. I just prepare and I think about every situation that Carlos Ocampo presents or that he possibly can present. Then we go from there. I just look at it for what it is, even in the ring. I go crazy. Like I told you, that I was, what, like 2 weeks ago? Yeah, in LA, yeah, messed up.
So, how has he looked in sparring? What has he been doing in sparring for?
He's been looking really good, man. He's very strong, you know. So, from the first day we started camp, right, he's like, I'm gonna spar 15. And we've been training. He said, I'm gonna spar 15 rounds today. I said, man, no, you're not. He said, yes, I am. I said, no, I don't believe you. So he has Adrian Taylor, who started 8 rounds with. He goes 7 rounds with Jamel. So Jamel is second. The heavyweight is first, right? The 200-pound guy first. And Jamel Charlo, the faster, smarter, intelligent guy, is second. So you think about that, you say, damn. So that's why in the latter part of the fights, he's stronger, he's better, because he's in there with better opposition.
How does he do against the heavyweight? I'm surprised he's doing this.
Hey man.
Where's the heavyweight?
I'm not gonna talk about it. He fight on the card, matter of fact.
Yeah.
He fight on the card.
Adrian Taylor.
Adrian Taylor, he's a 185 pounder. He got down to 185 this fight.
Okay.
So 187. So you see him out there. He's a good fighter too. Yeah.
But Errol puts it to him.
Hey man, I'm not gonna talk about that, man.
I got one more question for you. I know the moment's not too big for you or EJ. You guys are the most probably even killed tandem in boxing. But how special is it to, you know, being the trainer of a world champion in your hometown of Dallas? And fighting here Saturday night.
I don't know, man. I don't know, because I don't think about it. You know what I mean? Like, the thing about it, if I think about, man, I trained a world champion. So I'm walking around thinking about that.
And having to fight in Dallas Saturday.
You know, I don't think about it, because it's kind of crazy if I'm thinking, man, you know, shit, I just, you know. So if you think about that, it sounds great, right? But for me to think about it, it sounds crazy. So to me, But I think that, you know, you come in and go focus, just like if I had a guy who's 0-0. I'm still gonna put everything in him. I'm still gonna be happy because I'm still gonna stand there with him, as if, you know, if he lost 20 fights. So, but it feels, it's good to be in Dallas, man, for the fans, and regardless of if I train a world champ or not, I think that it's great to be here in Dallas and see the boxing come out. So when I grew up boxing in Golden Glove, we would get 11,000 people out every week in the Golden Glove. So with this fight, he got us beat, you know. So, but I think it's gonna be beautiful, man. I'm happy, man. I'm happy. But personally, I don't know how it feels. I don't think about it like that.
So now, Keir Thurman is not necessarily in the best favorable light with the fans. What's your whole take? Errol pressured him. He vacated his belt. And how would your fighter, Errol Spence, match up with Keith Thurman if they fight the same?
Well, first of all, I always choose my guy over everybody, right? But I don't think about Keith Thurman like that. I just think situations happen. I'm not going to say what pushed him to do this or to do that, because I have no idea. It's going to be hypothetical, and I'm not going to, you know, speculate, taking the extra energy out of my personal life. But hey, man, we'll do well against him. I think that it'll be another stoppage. I think he's stopping. I mean, if they were to fight, I believe that. But I mean, I don't think that would cause them not fighting. I just think he has other issues. I mean, you know, and whatever it is, I believe in my guy.